Hey guys, Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome to Let's Play Civilization 6 Japan Island Plate Emperor and Chill. We're just doing some Emperor and we're chilling. Actually, I've just noticed that I've already built this commerce hub, so I no longer need the tag for it. And now we're jumping right back into the game here with a couple of little actions. We're gonna end the turn and bring this unit over here and put him on alert. We're a bit of a military buildup. Have I slotted in the 100? Not quite. I'm not quite ready to upgrade all of these units, although some of them should be pretty close to getting upgrades. The crossbowmen are ready, and when do I get an upgrade for the pikemans, the pikemen? Not until chemistry, so there's a little bit of time to go here. I could grab a couple of rangers, actually. They're surprisingly decent. Do I have any scouts nearby? No, I'll definitely pick up like maybe two, maybe three rangers. I think that's pretty reasonable. Then I'll purchase upgrade. Ouch, getting hit a little bit over here, but it's no big deal. It's no big deal. I have a frigate over here that I want to get into range. Waiting for the turn to tick over. Okay, this frigate shall be in range. We may as well hit the city just to get the level up and do a little bit of damage. There we go. Unit needs orders. And this is my builder. How long until you grow? Oh, you already grew down here to this. So I think maybe I'll chop out a builder. Might be worth it. We'll see. What are you doing? Shooty shoot 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 here. I could level you up to get combat strength versus district defenses, and I will do that. I'm not in a rush to take this city. France is going to be a relatively easy opponent to defeat. Skip your turn. Now the question is here. Yes, you have grown, so you can do it. How about you start that industrial zone? Yes. No, not there. There. Yeah. But first, you're going to actually get another builder. And then we're going to harvest it out. And you build the builder, the industrial zone. And then we'll quick chop that over here also next to try and get it out as quick as possible. Okay, we have here Japan Caraval. Okay, where do you want to go? I think we're probably going to send some of these over here. So we need at least three caravels. So I'm going to send some over that way. That'll be reasonable. Oh my goodness, there's free scout. There's free settlers over here. I'll take them. I mean, they're not particularly useful to me, but I'll take them. Go into alert, please. And you also into alert. I think when you reload a save game, it takes units out of alert, oddly. Oh, excuse me, I have a little bit of a hiccup. Oh, excuse me. Okay, pikeman here. I don't know why. I've probably mentioned this before, but for some reason, right about the early time I start a series or I start recording, I just get kind of hiccupy and kind of belches and stuff like that. And I don't know what it is. It's a bit weird. It's not that it's weird. It's that it's weirdly consistent in that the fact that I've noticed a pattern means it's weird. Do you know what I mean? You should actually be ready. How about you just skip your turn then to eat a hit and then get an upgrade next turn. Now, Kyoto, you just built me a frigate, right? So actually, what I'm going to get you to do is get me a scout. Because I would like a scout to actually, well, I could get the electronics factory. It would be pretty good. This electronics factory would reach 1, 2, 3, 4. This would reach all of these cities. Wouldn't quite reach Sendai. But this place is building one. This one would be built first. And it would give me culture. But I think I'm gonna keep going for the military units here. And I did want a scout, so let me grab one. I'm already building a scout. That'll be fine. We'll sink one turn into a scout. And I could faith purchase a barracks here for a little bit of production. Although, it would give you a little bit of housing. So I'll faith purchase you a barracks. Just because, you know, I don't have anything else to use my faith on. And then I'll stick you down, probably a lighthouse to get you another little bit of housing. So you can keep growing. We have over here Nagano. Now, Nagano, you have finished your harbor. You're also going to want to think about what's next for you, because you have 7 population, you have a harbor, You don't have a trade route. I do have trade routes available. Why don't you just make me another trade route to send to some of my other core cities? Rio, I think I'll purchase you a barracks also so that you can get that little bit of production and housing. And how about you? I don't think you're working any unimproved tiles. You are working one unimproved tiles, and I could probably chip chop that and see how that went. Now, one thing I would actually like to build here is an industrial zone, but you won't be able to build that for a long time. It might be worth it to build an armory here to get the extra production. It's a pretty light city that's pretty light on production. I could probably use it. I could go for the housing from here. It doesn't need housing though, it needs a bit of production, so we'll grab the armory. Okay, here we have the field cannon, and that field cannon will be able to make its way over to Kish Kish Bang Bang. It'll take it a little bit of time to get over there, although I think I do have some roads in that direction. Yeah, there's a little bit of roadage. Why are you taking so long? That's so strange that it takes so long. Maybe have my roads not properly upgraded to be high-speed roads? That's a little bit weird. Maybe I should settle a city? I guess. Maybe I'll settle the harbor over here. Okay, so I have a trader here. Where is this trader? Okay, it's Okayama. I don't think Okayama is one of my core cities. So which of my core cities has the lowest production? Here's what I should be asking myself. So Urukai has 30, Shizuoka has 20, Gifu. So Shizuoka is the current candidate. Shizuoka still the current candidate. Shizuoka. Osaka. Why don't you transfer yourself to Osaka? Where is Osaka? There you are. Yeah, go there, helps Osaka. Osaka could use a little more production. Now you should head over to Kyoto because... Oh wait, no, Urukai has +4. Yeah, go to Urukai. Okay, I have a horseman here. And he should be able to eat a hit from this guy and, you know, be totally fine. We have here caravels heading on over to Poland. Polandia. Unit needs orders. Have these units fired? No, but they will. That should be a significant amount of damage to their city. You could do a hit here, but it wouldn't really be worth it. So we'll just unit needs orders and we'll capture the settler. And we just captured two settlers and we'll probably settle one over here. It seems like a reasonable thing to do. Probably France would have had a lot more cities had they not had that happen to them. 1, 2, 3. And yeah, this looks like a pretty reasonable place to stick it. It's got niter. It's got some cattle. It's got some tiles. It's you know. Not terrible. Now, if I were to harvest this, we'd significantly cut off a lot of turns on this. Which is what we were hoping for. Now, Manaus, did I capture you? No, I think I settled you, didn't I? I might have settled you. Did I capture a builder? I don't even remember. Honestly, don't even remember. But what I can do here is have a look at what tiles you're working. And I will be putting a campus there. So this is going to be mostly a growth city, not very much production, sadly. It's going to have to... That's why I'm building the industrial hub, right? Yeah, that makes sense. Now the question is, do I harvest here or do I... thing? And I think I... Oh... I think I harvest here. I think stone is kind of a poopy resource. So I think harvesting it is just the better choice. Now we have another builder with 5 charges and we can go around and do a little improving and stuff like that. Maybe even over here in Aomori, which actually has a really decent production because it has so many of these tiles. Wow, mines are just so good. Can we just talk about how good mines are for a moment? Mines are so good. It's ridiculous. Hakodate, a little bit of trouble growing. Ooh, took a shot there. Hurt him quite a bit actually, surprisingly. Now we should be able to do an owl pew pew. If I could grab this frigate, I guess I can't right now. We're going to do some production at Kyoto. I think we just made a scout, yep. And I made another field cannon. I could use a bombard. Let's make a bombard. Now this scout I'm going to be sending over to here. So choose production. Let's see, a market. We could do a... Yokohama is one of my things, one of my good cities. And you could use more housing. And the extra housing, what would an extra tile work to get you? You have all these improved. An extra tile worked wouldn't really get you much, to be honest. So it would probably be better to start investing in things like lighthouses or in markets. We have here a Frigates Auxilium. Why don't you head on your way over there? We have a trade route, and you should go to Uruk-hai because Uruk-hai is the good meme. Yep, plus four production. That's what we want. We want high production in our sort of central production cities. And you're going to be going to sleep here. And you're also going to be going to sleep here. So, three. We're building up a navy outside Poland for the forthcoming invasion of Poland. Sorry, Poland. Your land is just too nice for me not to try and take. Okay, we're still shooting the crap out of Paris. I think I will hit here because it'll get us a little speed things up just a smidge. Now, questionable decisions to be made here. I think I'm going to go over here and improve that mine because it will be very helpful. I think you're going to want to fortify as I try to escape with these acetylaes. Unit needs orders. You should skip your turn. You should skip your turn. Drop a farm there. And now this city will be able to work that farm, right? Yes. Because. Yeah, no, we're going to work these first. But we will work that farm eventually. We have a horseman here. We may as well do a little hit of it. Just for the extra bit of damage we do. Ooh. That horseman hit me. But that means we can challenge him and then settle there. Now, where am I going to... Oh, this settler was going over there, right? Okay. So, Lagash. Lagash, what were you going to do for me? There's probably a few things I could do with you. I think I've mostly improved. Yeah, there's not really much to do with your tiles. I think we've got a lot of building over here. I don't think I'll be wasting this. You don't need housing. You could use some production. There's not really a way to get you production. So this is just a city that needs to kind of bake in the oven for a while. I could get you a builder. That would probably improve your lot in life a little bit, give you some more options. So how about why don't we purchase you a builder just for the fun of it? We're gonna purchase a builder, and you're also going to be making a lighthouse to help you grow, help you get some money, help you catch up, do all that fun stuff. And we're gonna be settling a settler here. And this city is gonna be mostly just for fun. Is this also a hill? Yes, okay. Make me a builder and then just do that for a very, very long time. And I'm gonna just put three mines here. We're gonna shoot here. Think of this as like a refueling station. That's its only purpose. And the fact that I stole the settler, so it didn't cost me anything to actually put it there. Ah, there we go. That's more like it. Now we're gonna take the city. Oh my goodness. Purchase. Scout. There's so much going on over there. I don't even know what to say. Yeah, we'll be keeping all these cities because, they're extra production, they're extra culture, extra science. You should repair your monument. And you're gonna rest here. Regularum. Let me make your way around the corner. You're going to heal a little bit. Unit needs orders. Yes, I could put a farm here. I could. That would be a viable thing to do. Certainly wouldn't be terrible. Or I could get plus three production. And I think we know which one of those is the better choice. Because I just knocked 7 turns off this. Paris should fall next turn, I think. And we've unlocked diplomatic service, which is spies. Not really anything in here that I care too much about. Resident embassy, declare holy war. All that fun stuff. Those mechanics seem pretty slim in the current iteration of the game. I will be able to crush the city. I've lived long enough to know when I am defeated. Carry on. Thank you. A little bit disappointed that their units didn't become barbarians. Okay, knowledge of astronomy has increased dramatically. Probably some spaces left to settle cities that I could, you know, pop over here and stuff. But I think the world conquest is going quite well at the moment. I think it's going, you know, reasonably well. We have some good units over here. We've taken over France. I think we've taken over, I think Brazil was over here. I think Sumeria was over here. All we've got left is Russia and Poland. And was there someone else I took over? There was. I think there might have been. Okay, so there's going to be a simultaneous invasion of Russia and Poland. Not quite right now, but pretty reasonably soon. Now the question is, do I make a campus or an encampment? That is the difficile question. Ooh, theater square, that could be interesting. Industrial district, I could make you a trader. And that wouldn't be terrible because it would help you feed. It wouldn't give you any housing though, and we kind of need housing right now. Ancient walls won't give us any housing. We have the Great Lighthouse. Great Lighthouse. Ooh. And that would actually give me a... What would that do for me? Plus one movement for all naval units. That's actually fairly decent for a 12 turn investment. Is it worth it? I mean, it would give me some tourism, but I don't really need tourism. Would it give me anything else? Theater square. Market? No, I don't need a market. Do I need a market? I could use a market. It would give me more money, but I'm about to win, so it doesn't matter. Why don't you just make me more units? I could use another privateer. Why not? You know, why not? We'll do a little bit of repairing in Paris. And I think Paris just got added to my centralized production cities because I think the threshold now is over 20 production. So I have 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 central production cities, because any city that produces over 20, and the threshold will go up to 25 fairly soon. Any city that has over 20 production can produce units at a reasonable rate. Okay, we have here a builder, probably just going to be doing a lot of clearing and farming of this land. For the extra housing. Yeah, let's clear this marsh, put a farm on it. We're going to settle there. Yes. Okay, this land is actually fairly decent. Let's do some pinning here. We probably will never get around to placing this stuff. But we may as well. Okay, campus will be going there. Let's see. Now, unfortunately, I don't really have anywhere for the commerce hub to go. But I could do harbor. You could do a harbor here. And then commerce there. And then where would I put the industrial hub? Well, the industrial hub could fit pretty much anywhere, but if I put it there, I could do 2 mines and a thing, and we'll get plus 4. Oh my god, this is getting long. Okay, I need to go like through and kill some pins. Wait, you haven't built a harbor? You still haven't built a harbor. Amazing. I need to look for redundant pins that I've already used. I don't know what this is for. Was this for a campus? It was. You don't have any of that. Oh, you built your harbor. Okay, so we can delete that. Campus here. Oh, goodness. I need to get... Oh, yeah, we can get rid of that pin. Bring that list down a little bit, because that list has gotten out of hand in this current game. Alright, we'll have to work on that eventually. So let's see. Do you have any pins? Yeah, why don't you start building your... monument and stuff. You're not ready to do any of that. Ah, Kyoto! Have you sent one to Urukai? You have not. Urukai is worth plus 4, so that's quite decent. We're gonna rest these units. Actually, you need to level up. What if I... Can I wake you up? Oh, I already used up your turn. I don't like that it uses up the turn when I do the thing. Make your way over there. Oh no, you were supposed to go there. Jesus, what am I doing? Okay, yeah, why don't you go for rainforest and woods? Yeah, I think I'll grab this farm here so that Lagash has an interesting tile to work. This tile is slightly better than that. which is what we're hoping for. Oh my goodness, what, from what, Jesus Christ, Yadwiga. Get real with your deal. Give me the real deal, hey? Oh, this isn't good. Let's back the F up with this unit. Okay, we just unlocked coal. There should be coal all over our land. We should already have access to coal, yep. Let's just have a little peek. So here's some coal. Wow, 7 production tile. Damn. Oh, I accidentally crushed some coal over here. And here. And here. I'm not too upset about that one. Okay. Oh. I could do some fun stuff here. So there's like an amazing campus here, but also an amazing industrial district. So maybe campus here, industrial here, or industrial here, campus here. I think I have decided upon, like, I have a hard time valuing even districts over hill tiles because hill tiles are just so good. You do need housing. So why don't you grab a granary and then I'll kind of come back to you. What are you working at the moment? You're working these 5 tiles. These are pretty reasonable tiles to be working. I think I would also like you to go repair that. Okay, so you have built a harbor. That means I can get rid of that harbor pin eventually. Why don't you launch straight into a commerce hub? So we have Urukai here. Trader. Urukai. What could I do with you? I'm trying to think. I could grab you a trader. And that wouldn't be awful. I think I will grab some traders in my centralized production city. So you have over 20 production. You're still repairing yourself. I have a musketman here that I can send over to the mighty horde I'm building. I think I will be chopping this. Because I don't know why, but I would prefer to have something other than a thing there. Even a forest. When do I unlock the ability to drop forests? Is it with conservation? Yes, it is. So I think we will be grabbing conservation. I'm going to rest these units. They're a little bit hurt. Well, I say a little bit. They're pretty damn hurt. Although, weren't you ready for an upgrade? Yeah, I think I will grab the heals outside enemy territory is a pretty good one. It means you can rest up without having to run all the way home. I'm going to harvest that guy. And that will increase our population. And you'll grow again next turn. So next turn I'll be able to steal that builder. I want to be careful here. Manuela. Okay, we have artillery coming in. Did we ever get the... Did we ever get the Shooter McGavin? Where is he? Where is it? Oh, rifling. Here it is. Yeah, we'll be getting that eventually. Let's see. What are we working on right now? We're working on steel. So that's artillery and battleships. Do I have any units like that need upgrading? Actually, I do. Now, where could you go to get an upgrade? All right, head over here. And I think when this goes off, I could purchase this in Adam Smith. One economic... Oh, that's actually worth this purchase price here, in my opinion, perhaps. I could also just get a great general. I'm going to get him anyway, I think. Yes, I'm going to get him anyway. So I may as well go for... I mean, I may as well just wait a turn then. Oh my god, how am I getting 17.5 great general points per turn? Jesus Christ. Holy crap. Okay. Why don't you skip your turn? Skip your turn. Builder, what have you got to do for me? There's actually a lot of tiles that need repairing, so you should probably go do that. End this turn. Ooh, an impromptu horseman. That was not what I was hoping for. Claim great person. Yeah, I will be recruiting him. And then I will be choosing my production in Yokohama. Actually, excuse me, real quick. I'm actually going to end this episode and then we'll jump right back into things. I want to thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I'm having a great time playing. And I hope you guys are, you know, enjoying it too. I want to remind you that if you want to see the next episodes or just more content in general from me, that you can subscribe to my channel to get notified when new videos come out. I also want to let you know that if you want to directly support my channel, you can actually leave a like in the video and that will increase my rank on YouTube. It'll make me more visible. And, you know, it feels good. You know, you'd say, I like this guy. I like this content, you know, so do that if you wish. To help me out. And also, if you want to give me direct feedback on this episode, please remember to leave a comment. I like to read them. I like to get them. I like to have a bit of a conversation with people. I like taking suggestions. I like giving feedback and all that sort of stuff. So go ahead and do that. It's a lot of fun to participate. I hope you'll do that. And that's going to be it for this episode. I hope to see you in the next one. I love you all. Bye-bye.